Hello, my name is Bernard Divi, and you might know me by playing on the West forces or on the German forces more than anything else, but not on the Russian side. The thing is pretty clear, I never had the urge to ever grind a Soviet soldier, so, no, by now my German account is so far that I actually don't, I don't need anything to buy anymore on German side. Therefore, I decided I want to venture a bit into the art of Russian warfare. The only problem with that is that this account is what? That this this account is unfortunately a bit under-equipped, but when it comes to Russian stuff, now he hides. Such a pity. Long story short, I'm playing as Russian. This is the stage, of course. My main account is still locked in into the German faction and will be in the future. So I also lack anti-tank equipment, which is really, really bad in this situation, I must say. The soldier I'm playing right now is most basic. It's just a freshly bought major. His why would you run around with the MP43? Ugh. Oh, you're not my friend. We are playing with a Tokarev S40-40, a nice weapon that cannot beat MG43. Damn. Well, the sense of this video is to more or less showcase the capabilities of the Russian basic weaponry. I personally think the Tokarev is one of the best semi-automatic rifles, if not the best semi-automatic rifle in this game. The build I'm currently playing is quite simple, which is mostly because I didn't have so much time to grind. I just bought this gas, so I don't have to wait or walk all the time, and you guys have to watch the weird thing while I'm walking around. While it would be better if I would do that for my heavyset grind. I'm playing the Tokarev with only the scope and the scout 2 barrel. This means that upon occasion you actually need 3 shots to kill someone. If you would play with ammunition, the chances are kind of higher to kill with only 2 shots. But the thing is, the Tokarev is actually already has a somewhat high fire rate that enables me to I think it's okay. I win most melee encounters, if not against the highest tiers of weapons, so an MG42 and an MG34 are most of the time out of question, and I definitely won't beat a carbine in melee fights, but for everything else, the time to kill for any given weapon is really low, which is nice. I also regret a bit to have bikes of gas, but I definitely need a vehicle, so otherwise I had to walk a lot, and I actually want the Cosmolet. There's of course always a guy upstairs. Panzer of Mine lang. Interesting. Yeah, this is, by the way, as already mentioned before, a stage battle, and I should probably save a bit of money, because, as always, I would like to showcase how to save money. The thing is, with this build, is I'm currently, my grinding goal is the AVS. I know, yeah, the AVS is bad. I want to see it myself, and in the last few weeks, I picked up an AVS more than once, and I personally thought that this is a nice gun, but you more or less definitely need fast reload gold or a pistol. I will probably go the pistol route, cause grinding up to fast reload gold is a really time consuming thing. And I don't think I want to do this anytime soon, so this guy will probably die. Nope. The thing is, Tokarev's scope is a really nice gun in the sense that the zoom is a bit less than in the with the German weaponry, really, and a bit more than with Garand. So you have a 3.5 zoom, which is actually kind of nice. I, by the way, despise the battle I got here. It's in the middle of the night. I personally like the forward airfield the most, but night battles are really not to my liking, because it will be super dark in the woods. But I guess I will use this to my advantage. If not, tanks see me. That could be a problem, because as you see, my gas doesn't even has a crate on it. Otherwise, I would probably put a Panzerfaust 60 crate on it. So there we have another tank. I think actually light tanks are harder to beat than medium tanks if you have nothing against tanks. Because they are pretty annoying. They are good against infantry because they have fast MGs, are somewhat fast in movement, and so on and so on and so on. So the situation doesn't look so good, but actually this line is kind of bowing, right? I should probably that was a luck shot. to showcase the capabilities of the Tokarev, I should probably let the Germans more at once, which is apparently not happening, but on the B line, it looks like there are more Germans. Like, I mean, you see that advances of the German forces on this line are rather... please don't kill me yet. or rather slow and weak. Yeah, I guess they focus on the B-line. But it's a stage match, so they should probably focus on keeping one line open, but I can see why no one wants to play the D-line, because the D-line sucks. You have to walk over a wide open field to get to the point, which is, if you have new vehicles, super annoying. But it's... in any situation, it's not nice. Here, there's no... Oh, wait. Actually, there is a free Panzer 460 here. This is, by the way... those lightning battles are, by the way, a nice nice way to grind up your... Oh, I actually in the... Oh. Wow. Okay, this is fortunate. So, I think I will just go ahead and farm some tanks if I don't die from this guy. Cause... As soon as I get... What? Didn't hit. As soon as I get tank destruction full, I can finally throw RPGs. Whether my too high, really. Any kind of anti-tank equipment would be really appreciated. Not a bazooka, because a bazooka would be too big for the moment. Ah, finally hit. No, no, he saw me. Oh, this is even a level 1 tanker. What? Wait. This guy is? Huh? For the record, this guy is level. Okay, I have to go through 3 anyway. This guy is level 1. So he has still a circle, so no level up. Oh, this. If the picture hadn't been so great, it would have been looked super epic. This guy has a Panzer 2C, but has not gained any experience. I mean, you need like 50 experience to level up the first time. Damn it! Another thing is this soldier doesn't have heavy set. Oh, well, he has. By now, he has heavy set. I have Maritiman and heavy set Bronze, which is. Not really to my liking, but what will I do? I had to play more to have higher ranks on those badges. I will probably, but this is... Currently I'm playing this account only when I'm not doing anything else. Like when I'm not streaming, when I'm not playing with friends, so it's just in the one or two games in the afternoon. So the grind till I have the... till I have the AVS will probably take a long time. And that again? No, I'm not. I'm still thinking. I guess I could get... Oh, there's another... Oh, wait, it's a Russian tank. Speaking about Russian tanks, this is not a Russian sniper. I'm so stupid. I would like to kill the other guy that is just hacking the tank. Ooh. Oh, a tank killed this guy. Okay. So I could now drive tank, but I don't want to. I have no joy in driving a tank around. That's... Actually, I am getting sad when I drive tanks around, because I always get hunted down. It's a matter of seconds till some guy with H3s or anything basically is standing behind me. I'm too thick. I see nothing. Thanks, Vito. Oh, okay, this guy's dead, but... Yes, this guy's also dead. Ugh. I will never get to kill anything here. So at least we defend this thing. What is my squad even? Oh, I don't have a squad. Okay, so my squad is doing nothing. Of course it doesn't exist. Okay, well. And I won't get any squad members. Okay, that's a pity. I mean, I don't really have a use for X-ray experience, but still, I would take it. Just because I have. I don't actually know. Can someone, by the way, confirm or deny that you get credit boni when some of your squad members are running, doing objectives? Because I never figured out if that is the case or not. I know that there is a small reward for doing kills, but I don't know if the whole squad thing is giving you anything. I guess I want to buy a bazooka at some point. I could, but it cost me 40,000 credits. I don't have that right now. I mean, it's exactly the setup I play on German side as well. Scope Gewehr 43 versus the Panzerschreck is basically a good all-rounded setup that brings that. Actually wins you games in most of the situations, except if there's a looks like standing out of nowhere. The thing is, I cannot change. And by the way, I also have a second Russian soldier. Yeah, what? Oh, this guy actually cannot give orders because he's level 4. Oh man, doesn't matter. This is my second soldier I played a long time ago. Dual setup, it's basically the baby dual setup, but I never continue playing that setup just simply for the fact that he'd earn no money at all playing a level 4 soldier, and I don't feel good when playing a level 4 soldier. I actually like to earn money even if I play on soldiers I don't even can use in the war, so I would rather play with a major I freshly bought and have to grind up a new than with this guy. British Buttock. I know this guy. By the way, this sound is really... What happened to those music thingies? Sounds and music? Were they always disabled? I never paid attention to this, so I have no clue. So there's this luck looks on the field, so I should probably seek cover. Yes. As I already said, I should probably seek cover, and I guess I need to go back to the O3, cause you just lose it. I wanted to peek. Well, this guy has the looks. That's the highest highest tier lighting the Germans have. So I assume this guy will not peek. Especially because the looks is so fast, you usually don't... Oh, hey, defended it. You usually don't need to peek. You can just drive away and... In most of the cases it works. So let's go here. But I'm actually missing the infantry? Whoa. There's no infantry at all on the field. This is really strange, so to speak, because... I mean, we haven't seen a ground soldier since a long time. Are there only tanks on B-line? And if yes, who captured all those points? Yeah. Oh, fuck. Okay, so the question is answered. There is infantry. It's just, well, not around. Okay, let's spawn a car. This is, I need to level up this thing anyway. I need a med pack on it. Oh, which Buttock is dead as well. What a pity. So, yeah, but we are about to close the D-line. Then the amount of people that are on the B-line should increase. Or this game will be over in... Oh, well, there are so many lightings. I cannot fathom that this fight will be over soon. Oh, fuck. This sounds like... Something stupid that can kill me. Ooh, look. It looks. Oh, who are you? Did I already mention that I really like the hipfire capabilities of the Tokarev? It's quite astonishing how good this weapon is. I mean, sometimes... Oh, fuck you. Sometimes you're not... Eh? Where's the guy? Oh. Okay, he has no chance at all to ever hit with that MP42. Oh wait, he can randomly headshot me. That would be unfortunate. I don't want that to happen. I think but I should more worry about this guy. I mean, this one is... One. Woo. Yeah. Important sniper lesson. Always stay far behind the windows. Because you never want to stand exactly at the window. I mean, it's enough if you see the area you want to see. Wait, I should probably adjust my scope. I hate T-post scopes. But I'm not going... Ah, really? But I'm not going to make this guy a... Oh, wait, I cannot make this guy a sniper, but I would... Wouldn't do it anyway, because when you have a sniper, you can actually buy the other scope, the German 4, I think it's called. You know, there's a better one, where you can actually hit something and aim, and you just not have to guess where to aim. So the D-line is soon be over, and if they don't reinforce... Oh, yeah, actually, the Germans are in lower numbers? What is happening here? I'm a bad sniper. Someone is counter-sniping me. I don't appreciate that. So let's see if you see any movement here. Yeah. I really suck at sniping. He will probably not hit me. But there's also a guy inside, so I should probably... Yeah. I was a bit close. I should probably pay more heat to the other guy. What? Oh well. I'm dead. I will live again. I live, I die, I live again. It's basically the motto of every first person shooter ever. Except maybe Counter-Strike, where you... And other similar games where you, when you die, you have to wait. So B3 spinners. I wonder if now that the entire focus on the B-line, they will actually be more successful. At least the lightings got cut in the half, so they only have 20 left. That's something. I mean, lightings are the most annoying of all tanks. Oh, they are... But they are really lacking vehicles. That will devolve into a problem. Or evolve? When you have a problem and you have something, does it devolve or evolve into a problem? I mean, you can also use the word transmute. English is such a fascinating language. Anyway, I would love to have RPG 43s or... I think in this situation I actually would prefer to have a bazooka. Oh wait, no, scratch that, I don't want a bazooka. I want, if anything, I want to have a... Panzerschreck. I cannot work with the sights of the bazooka. It's just too weird for me. My American soldier still hasn't unlocked it, and I'm really cursing every time I need to kill something. And the stupid bazooka sights are just not working. Oh, there's a guy that is. Nice. 3 kills. Good thing you can see stuff like this as walls. So this should, yeah, I should probably go. Oh, wait, was there a Sturmgewehr? Sturmgewehr? Yes, a Sturmgewehr! Excellent. I mean, I'm by the way actually super able to put, lol, super able to pronounce Sturmgewehr, but I'm not doing so, cause, well, that is how I think it's how it how it's pronounced in English. Sturmgewehr. Despite being actually German. oh, fuck. I could have killed this guy. I like the SDG. I think it will be better in the next update. This is right now. It's a day. Whatever the name of this update is. Big advantage of the SDG is. Oh, fuck. Leave me alone. Is. Die already! Oh, fuck. I'm so dead. Ach, I even died to this guy? I thought I can at least take one with me. Oh well. I tried. So we are losing this point again. Oh, we have a sniper slot? It doesn't matter anyway, but I should probably make. I don't have any other Russian soldiers as those two infantrists, but I should have probably made it to a tank slot. Because I guess one can do more with the tank slot. Okay, we will see. Find another nice weapon. Damn it! Or I will find only death. Right now I'm grinding for the AVS, but it's certainly true for all the other things as well. If you're grinding for the carbine or the SCG, you definitely want to pick up any gun that also levels up infantry assault and is more efficient than the gun you have. Like, you definitely want to pick up any one-shot bolt action rifles, so make sure that the trigger and the heavy bolt inside, the barrel, you need to. Normally no one plays with a not chrome lined barrel, whatever the name was, a stainless steel barrel. Nobody plays ever with a stainless steel barrel, so if a K90A, a Mosin or a M193 has a barrel and the other thing, you can be somewhat sure that. You can be somewhat sure that it's a one-shot rifle, and you definitely want that, cause bolt action rifles are approximately leveling infantry assault twice as fast, if not even faster. Like twice as fast. I don't actually know the metrics, but I know that bolt action rifles are actually faster. Back in the days when you could buy the bolt action rifle really early, it was actually a good idea to just go for your one-shot bolt action rifle to grind this one up and then grind infantry assault, because this is faster than with the old SA rifles. Since the introduction of the Scout 2 barrel, I think it's actually just cheaper and better when you just grind it with a Scout 2 barrel and maybe a scope. What? Where? Oh, really? That, by the way, for the stuff that only the Russians are spawn capping. As soon as you play other factions, you will realize that all the factions are spawn capping, all the factions are spamming tanks, and all the factions do anything you accuse them of doing. Oh, well, the PTRD spawn camping is probably a thing that is limited to the Russians, but you get the point. Speaking about PTRD, I don't have one. Which is really sad. I will buy one at some point, I guess. But I wonder if I'm willing to grind up a second soldier for this. I mean, for what do you get the PTRD? I think for grinding up infantry, tank destruction. Don't know. But this is far from the talk. I still have some. The other day I realized I have some stuff to buy on German side. Most. Oh, I hear K90A. I think I want this one. Can I maybe sneakily kill someone? Yep, there's definitely the guy on my home. Oh. Okay. Anyway. No, leave me alone. No! I hate this guy! Ugh. What do we want from me? He doesn't even get the weapon, cause the weapon is. Ugh. Yeah, this was bad reaction from me. I should have just thrown away the K90A or take it and then flee the scene. But regardless of what I did, it was wrong. So, can I maybe take revenge? Probably not. Oh, this guy is a Kettenrad? No, wait. There's no one on.
What? How?
I don't get it. How was this guy able to instantly kill me? I certainly heard only one shot and I was shooting for what? No, the ping on this is good. I mean, this guy already killed me a few times before and this wasn't even the headshot. Okay, I'm kind of surprised how he was able to do this. Or maybe he has a high fire weight, Gewehr 43. This could be. I didn't pay attention if this guy is dead by now. At least I can pick up my own Tokarev. That saves up some money. That's something. I mean, I just spent a lot of money in spawning another gas. It's like 72 credits per each. Right, this is not so I can go outside. I see nothing. Look at this fire rate and the stability. I have basically no mods to increase the fire rate, and yet I think the fire rate is totally okay. Look at this. I can even more or less consistently hit a target as big as it looks. That's something. As said, I really think that the Tokarev is a nice gun. That is that every young Russian soldier should consider to use instead of going the PPD route. Because with the PPD, you're really cursing a lot. I know that. Because even with the highest fire rate PPD, you are in most of the situations you are just bad off, and you will even lose melee encounters you could win with the Tokarev. So there's that. Look at this! Awesome stability. Okay, this was more locks than anything, but the hip fire accuracy of the Tokarev is actually kind of okay. So I recommend it. It's just important to know when to use the scope and when to actually use the hip fire. Like from this distance, I would never use. Wait, I actually hit something from it. But whoa, I got points for being alive. Like this distance from this end to the other end is probably a weird thing between hip fire. I mean, you can when I crouch, I can somewhat consistently hit the same spot, but that's not. I would probably use the scope in this situation. There are some situations where the 2.2 scope of the Mürkens are actually better. This is one of them. So let's see if we have any snipers here or anything. This guy again. Now I have to be a bit careful so I don't get sniped by a tank. Would be rather unfortunate. Yeah, this position is a bit. No, it's not a bit bad, it's pretty bad because all the tanks are spraying inside. Adjust my sights to 100. So yes, there will be some. Ah, the lack of anti-tank equipment is really telling here. Yeah. I guess I will see sniper. Oh, wait, I should probably. Is this mine? Yes, this is my guess. Okay, I have a new idea. Just need to not die by ramming into a random wall. That would be unfortunate. Let's see if this works. This battle is, by the way, soon be over. The Germans didn't give us a really good fight. It's a bit surprising because the other games I did today were somewhat big. Woohoo! No, no! No! Oh, why are there so many people here? Annoying. I just wanted to snipe at the bridge. The other battles I had with the Russians today were not really enlightening. I got a good amount of kills, but our team lost anyway. Okay, one was against heavy tanks. Not many people that play on Russian side actually own a heavy tank, so the Tigers were just scrambling through, and most people try to kill a Tiger with a Panzerfaust 60. This is not. Oh fuck! There are so many people upstairs. Oh, this was a random grenade. I guess I want to. What is this? It's a PPS. Yeah, I will take it. Oh, what? Okay, this is annoying. I want to get upstairs in this house, and I will do it. I mean, I have nothing better to do anyway. I could try to snipe, but I personally think sniping is boring. Just standing around in one corner and waiting till this one guy is coming along is pretty boring, and you get nothing out of it. You get something out of it. The pure satisfaction that the other one is probably most likely raging hard because you are hanging out in a totally random position. People do that way too much. This guy has PPSH, that could be a bit hard to beat with my Tokarev. I think he's already damaged, so. Alright, oh, I just let this guy storm the front. Oh, it's empty? Awesome. So I can now set up myself. Oh, I would just suck at aiming it. Having a scope in this situation is really a big advantage. So I can probably. Actually, this is a bad sniping spot because the entire forest there can be littered with German snipers. So I don't think this is a good sniper spot. But as long as I live, I will just stay here. I could probably try some. Yeah, I could. Next life, I will try some swimming lessons if the time allows it. I mean, right now it looks like, yeah, the Germans are rage quitting. Okay. So this battle is soon to be over. Yeah, but just take my car and finish this. I mean, most of the people are left, so I guess this battle is, that's my guess, okay. So the guess this battle is supposed to be over. Oh wait, there was another German. I got him. Oh, this guy again. Bordo Borelli, 21. He never gives up. Oh, this, no! This was a guy with SCG, if I saw it correctly. On the other hand, I must say, this is a stage match. This is really to be kept in mind. I mean, in staged. Normally, I think the players are, in average, are better in stage matches than in war matches. Actually, because for some weird reasons, everyone and his mother wants to grind in war matches, where you getting beaten by clans. Then you go to the forums and whine about it, that clans are beating you in the elite mode. Of course, you cannot grind properly. Yeah, many people are just playing war for 50% more. I cannot do that, for obvious reasons. But I see that people do that a lot. Therefore, in stage matches, you either have the totally hopeless noobs, and you have the full geared pro players that just want to try something, or just want to play a fun match. Wait, don't have to put a lot of effort. There's a tank, I hope he's just not bad. Of course, he's just aiming this direction. I could probably wait to get B2. I don't think. Yeah, we are. Oh, we actually do close this. Course, there's definitely more time than 13 infantry life. Yeah, Vito still hasn't fixed it, and with the downsizing of the ATs, you, especially in stage matches, you're going so often to stations that you're so often going to the situation that the enemy team just lacks the infantry spawns to just end the match. It's like, if the Germans had like 60 or 50 or 80 more spawns, it would be an easy thing. But, so it, it would be more fair if the Germans would just get, like, say, one mechanized guard more. Mechanized guard isn't a thing. It should be a thing, so the stupid trucks wouldn't take up super valuable APC slots, but it will be like this. On the other hand, who would ever deploy mechanized guards? I personally would never do that. I mean, why should I enable some stupid idiots to drive around trucks that die instantly? No, I would rather not do that. Wait, is there... I probably just will just die once more. I don't want to die. Yeah, it was not a really successful round. I did some stuff, but... I can give myself orders. Yay. But, yeah, this battle ends by infantry. Yeah, there are 5 spawns left. If only they had a few more spawns, it would be a lot fairer. I mean, imagine they had gotten to capture O3. By now, they would probably try to capture O1, and then they will run out of infantry spawns. And despite being successful against the hard defense, they couldn't win this game by any means, because the other line got close. It's a bit stupid. I think there's no real disadvantage to overstack lines with infantry, at least. I mean, it's one thing to put more tanks on the lines, but... Oh, no, no, no! This guy again. What? I should probably have not fired on the tanks. That was a bit stupid. Oh, well. Yeah, this match is soon to... No, don't die. Don't die. Don't die, Genovit. Don't die. What is he doing? Oh, this guy makes me weak. Oh, we have a tank. Oh, T-70. It should be actually game. Yeah, 50 seconds left. Actually, I'm not able to close this. This is sad. Oh, no, I'm only third best. No, I need to kill someone. But there's a tank who probably will kill me. Oh, so bad. Yeah, they are out of infantry spawns now. So everyone who is still alive is probably camping because he isn't dead yet. Or sits in it. Oh, wait, never mind. There's exactly one infantry guy left. So all the other guys are sitting in tanks. Like, this is... No, wait, this looks actually empty. Yeah, it's empty. Yeah, I have no clue where the last few are, but... Anyway. 20 kills, 24 deaths. Yeah, I didn't play this match well, but... Oh, well, it was dark, it was night, and I wanted to show anything. So, but this is the Tokarev. A nice gun, as I want to say. It's pretty useful, and it's... somewhat cheap to use. And it still really shows results. That's the main reason why I like it. So I hope this was somewhat useful for you and you enjoyed the playthrough. We see us next time. And leave me some comments. I really love comments. Goodbye.